गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 5, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ मैथ्स. एंड बिफोर द PT2 असेसमेंट वी वर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 11, एरिया एंड इट्स बाउंड्री. सो वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम चैप्टर टुडे ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज माई रिक्वेस्ट टू एवरी वन, काइंडली टेक आउट योर मैथ मैजिक बुक एंड चैप्टर नंबर इज 11. ओके, सो क्विकली टेक इट आउट. इन चैप्टर नंबर 11, एज द topic is area and its boundary. We were doing the sums related to the area and the boundary. Boundary means related to the perimeter. And as you know, there are two formulas for the area and for perimeter. Perimeter of the rectangle, 2 into L plus B. And area of the rectangle, L into B. Similarly, perimeter of the square, 4 into side, and area of the square, it is side into side, isn't it? So by these formulas, we are finding out the area and perimeter, or area and the boundary of different things. Okay, so for page 146 and 147 we have already completed, and related to page 147, in page 148 there are some fill in the blanks which we have already completed, isn't it? In our class we have already completed the fill in the blanks which was related to page 147 with that stamps. I think you remembered, with that stamps we have completed. Okay, so today we will start practice time. Practice time of page number 148. So this is my request to everyone, kindly open page number 148. Page number 148. Math Magic. Page 148, Math Magic. I'm going to read the question. See, question number A. Arbaz plans to tile his kitchen floor with green square tiles. Each side of the tile is 80 centimeter. His kitchen is 220 centimeter in length and 180 centimeter wide. How many tiles will he need? Now see, Arbaz, a boy, he want to put tiles or pave tiles in the floor, in the kitchen floor. Okay, and the length and breadth of the kitchen is given, that is 220 centimeter by 180 centimeter, and the side of the tile is given. As the tile is a square tile, that's why only the one side is given, and it is 10 centimeter. You have to find out that how many tiles are needed to pave the whole floor. Okay, to pave the whole floor, clear? So what you will do, first of all you will find the area of the kitchen floor. Okay, then you will find the area of the tile, and by dividing this two, you will find the number of tiles needed to put it in the kitchen floor, okay, or to pave in the kitchen floor. So let us start writing this one. Number A, this is page number 148, practice time, question number A. Okay, so first of all you will write length of the kitchen floor. Length of the kitchen floor is equals to 220 centimeter. Then you will write the width. It is given the width, not the breadth. Width of the kitchen floor, it is 180 centimeter. And then you will write, or then you will find the area. Area of kitchen floor is equals to L into B, isn't it? That means 220 into 180 square centimeter. So just multiply. 2 zeros, 8 2s are 16, carry 1. 8 2s are 16 plus 1, 17. 2 and 2, when you are adding 6, 9, 3. And these 2 zeros will be added. That means we are getting this number as the area. All have completed? Okay. Now write the next one. Length, not length, side of the square tile. One more is given. Side of the square tile. It is 10 centimeter. It is given 10 centimeter. Therefore, area of the tile. Side into side. That is 10 into 10. That is 100 square centimeter. Okay, now you have to find number of tiles. So you will write number of tiles is equals to area of floor divided by area of tile is equals to two zeros cancel and we are left with 396 tiles. See, this type of question we have already done in composite maths. Okay, so the answer you will write that Arbaaz needs 396 tiles. Arbaaz needs 396 tiles for his kitchen floor. For his kitchen floor. Arbaaz needs 396 tiles for his kitchen floors. Okay. Yes, you have done the correct one. This is Aditya. Yes, Aditya, it is correct. Okay, now come to number B. Quickly come to number B. Number B is given, the fencing of a square garden is 20 meter in length. How long is one side of the garden? The fencing is given, that means the perimeter is given of the square garden. It is 20 meter. You have to find the length of one side. So you have to find the one side of the garden. So quickly find it out. Since the perimeter is given, you have to find the side, one side. So what you will write? Perimeter of the square garden. Number B, perimeter of square garden. It is given 20 meter. Therefore, one side of square garden is equals to what you will write? Perimeter by 4, isn't it? Because perimeter is equals to 4 into side. So for one side it will be perimeter by 4, that is 20 by 4, that is 5 meter. So answer you will write, one side of the garden is 5 meter long. One side of the garden is 5 meter long. One side of the garden is 5 meter long. Okay. Now come to question number C. Any doubt for question number A and B? Any doubt to anyone for question number A and B? No, no. Now come to question number C. Question number C. A thin wire 20 centimeter long is formed into a rectangle. If the width of this rectangle is 4 centimeter, what is its length? Now the same thing is given here also. The perimeter is given 20 centimeter and the length of the rectangle is given. The width of the rectangle is given 4 centimeter. You have to find the length. So this is also, put it in the formula, that 2 into L plus B, and then find out B. So you write it down. perimeter of the rectangle is equals to perimeter of the rectangle is equals to 20 centimeter. Then width of the rectangle is equals to four centimeter. You have to find the length. So what you will write? Since perimeter of rectangle is equals to 2 into L plus B. Now the perimeter is given 20 is equals to 2 into L plus B is given 4. So this will be 20 divided by 2 and this will be L plus 4. And L is equals to 20 divided by 2, 10. And this 4 is in plus. When it will come this side, it will be minus. So 10 minus 4, that is 6 centimeter. 6 centimeter. So the answer will be 6 centimeter. The length of the rectangle is 6 centimeter. The length of the rectangle is 6 centimeter. Okay, completed. Now quickly come to number D. See, number D is a square carom board has a perimeter of 320 centimeter. How much is its area? Now the square carom board perimeter is given 320 centimeter and you have to find the area. So what you will do, first of all you will find the side, because without the side you will not be able to find the area. So perimeter of the square carom board will be 4 into side. So from there you will find the side, and from side you will put it in the formula of area, that is side into side, and you will find the area. Okay, so let us do this one. This is page number 149. This is page number 149, question number D. First of all, what is given? Perimeter of square carom board. It is given 320 centimeter. So you will find the side. Since perimeter of square is equals to 4 into side, so side is equals to perimeter by 4, isn't it? That means 320 by 4 centimeter. When you will cancel, it will be 80 centimeter. 4 8s are 32 and 0 will be as it is. Therefore, area of square carom board is equals to side into side. That is 80 into 80 square centimeter. Now 80 into 80 is 64 square centimeter. Okay, so you will write the answer that area of the carom board is area of the carom board is 6400 square centimeter. 6400 square centimeter. Okay, it will be square centimeter, not only centimeter, because area is always in square centimeter. Okay. Yes, question number E, you will do it of your own in the book. Okay, and from tomorrow we will do question number F. So students, today up to this only. Whatever you have done, you once more you practice at home, because this all questions, it is related to area and perimeter. So you once more practice it in your copy. Okay, and bye all of you for today.